Let's take a look at the top 10 plays.
Number one, Indiana and Northwestern. Now, this is an interception. This is a one-handed interception by Kyle Queiro.
Show off.
This is just no simple one-handed interception. He had no choice.
Oh.
He had to do the one-handed grab because he's got a cast on the other hand. I got it. Northwestern wins 24-14.
Sports Centers.
Johnson facing pressure from Gaziano, and he's picked off. Straddling the sideline is Kyle Queiro. Touchdown, Northwestern. That is a Houdini act by the senior from New Jersey, Kyle Queiro, with his eighth career interception.
I think that's going to stand. And pick six. Unbelievable, the concentration here.
About a yard and a half to go here for Indiana. Now Lego's going to throw for it on fourth down. Looking, now he dumps it off. It's caught, but short of the first down. Well short. Page made the catch, and he's wrapped up right away by Kyle Queiro.
Hogan out. Intercepted. Picked off by Queiro.
And instead of trying to take it to the house, we shut it down so they can come out and take a knee.
DiNucci to throw. Rolling. Firing. Intercepted! Queiro has it! And Kyle Queiro will give Northwestern a victory with that interception.
Kyle Queiro, a guy who we thought got nicked up at the beginning of this game. Just a great read on the route right there. Puts his foot in the ground, cuts underneath.
Dodds is going to pass. Completes it out near the 40-yard line to his tight end, Ethan Wolf, who's tackled immediately for Corey Davis. Rebion Franklin in the flat. Very little room to go after the catch. Kyle Queiro, the strong safety, making the tackle.
Clean pocket, but it's picked. Intercepted right around the goal line by Kyle Queiro, the senior.
And you want your seniors to come up with big plays, especially an experienced senior like Kyle Queiro. He did a nice job of baiting Ganji. And faded back and made a nice play. Nice job by Queiro reading that quarterback.
Fumble recovered.
I'm around a guy next to you right now. This is the guy that you've been working with. This is the guy that you've been working with. The guy that's been getting you better. I know you're not going to let that guy next to you down.
No.
But right now, 30 minutes, the guy next to you.
Jonathan Taylor stretching to the outside. He's wrestled down inside the five.
Barkley dropped for a loss. Kyle Queiro.
Start.
Dumps it off underneath to Antra. Good open field tackle.
Yeah, he loves what he's seen so far. Croft going to try to go back to the air on a deep ball, and oh, he underthrew it. It's picked off. Intercepted by Kyle Queiro.
Surprising college football.
Coming up
Lee on third down, pressure coming,
and it's intercepted. Picked off by Kyle Queiro, who takes it out of bounds inside the 30-yard line.
And Queiro did a nice job of undercutting this ball.
Second and 12 off play action.
Lee looking deep for Morgan. Jump ball, and it's incomplete. Queiro in the area. Huskers have all three timeouts. Lee. And it's intercepted. Picked off for the second time today by Kyle Queiro. And now it's Northwestern with a chance to score before halftime. Third down and seven at the 48. Lee over the middle. Tipped and incomplete. Queiro with an outstanding play. Spielman was that close to a touchdown.
Spielman got on top. Queiro undercut it and got his hand on the ball. Or that's six quick. Really well defended. Ball needs to come up just a tad more. Just a fingernail more.
That's an outstanding play by Kyle Queiro. I'm winding down a tie game in the fourth. Draw play Ozigbo. Met by Queiro and driven back. Excellent play by the safety. Third and five. No pressure. Lee. Intercepted again. Queiro nearly had another pick. Fourth and 11. Ball game right here. Lee. Pass deflected, incomplete, and Northwestern wins it in overtime.
You know, I think both Godwin and Kyle have really grown. I've really been impressed with their maturity. I think they've done a terrific job leading these last couple of years. They learned from some great ones, too, and they're fortunate for that. But they're both playing at a high level. Both guys, I think, are just outstanding teammates and have very bright futures. I think both are going to get an opportunity, and if they get an opportunity, I think they're going to play for a long time on Sunday because they've both got different skill sets, but they've got, I think, Sunday talent and definitely Sunday attitude and work ethic. So excited to have them for a couple more games. And then Kyle, you know, just it's a family affair there, you know, with both. I had the privilege of coach both he and his brother Cam and, you know, his mom and dad. It's just been great. It seems like yesterday that I walked into his house in New Jersey. So it's an emotional week for me. You know, I go back with a lot of these guys to start in the recruiting process when they were 15, 16 years old. To see the men that they've become while going through our program, I'm just really proud of them. They come from great families, so we're a big leg up when they first get here. But just very proud of the men that they've become and excited not only for the last few games with them, but also excited for their futures.
All three of you maybe could answer, what does it mean to be ranked in the top 25, and especially after your start that you had? Does it give you a little extra incentive to keep it going?
No, I don't look at rankings at all. We know what we have in our locker room. We know what we have in this room, and whatever they think of us outside of it doesn't change anything.
Unfortunately, I might say the opposite. as a senior, and you know, leader in the defensive back group, you know, I just challenged our guys in our room that, you know, this is going to be our last opportunity as seniors, and we want to go out not only on top every single week, but also just put Northwestern on the platform even further for years to come, and just continue to gain respect for the program. And Coach Fitz talked about, you know, potentially getting bored with winning. I wanted to make it clear that it needs to be a habit. So, and that it just needs to be an infectious, contagious thing that, you know, it's hard to win in the Big Ten, and we need to continue doing it. Won't you follow me into the jungle?